Praise God, my name is Redemptor Moke. I'm a born-again Christian. I believe in Jesus Christ. He died, he resurrected, and Jesus Christ is God. So basically today I'm going to share one of my dreams that I had a very long time ago. I was out of YouTube for a couple of time, and every time I wanted to record this video, it will just not happen. But good thing I wrote it, and this is a perfect time to release this video. So this specific dream, it was actually a dream, not a vision, as I remember very clearly. This dream happened in June 10, 2018 at 8:30 a.m. And in this dream, it looked like I was in a different county. I specifically come from a place called Nairobi. So I traveled to a place called Mombasa. And there was a function going on of superheroes, the Marvel superheroes, Spider-Man, Superman, almost all the Marvel character, cartoon characters, so many characters were there, Disney character. And we were there to motivate them, to support them, and to encourage them to perform. And then again, the scene changed. I was with one of my friends, someone that I know personally by the name of Catherine, and she saw me with this padlock. This padlock looked like it had a front camera of the phone, like this, exactly like a front phone camera. And she looked at him and she said, "Do not ever buy this padlock again." And I said, "Why?" "Because it can be unlocked from the other side, so be very careful." So I heard what she said, but I snubbed it. And then the scene again changed. I was in a place that looked like my own house, like I had my own family and I was married. I personally don't have a house of my own. I am not married and do not have the desire to have a family as of yet. So in this scene, I was in my own house and I took my phone and I called my husband. And he picked and he was like wanting something, and then we talked and we hung up. And then I could see like two scenarios. I could see myself in the house and the padlock that I had used to lock my door. I could see like somebody could watch me. And by the time I was concentrating, I was like, who is watching me from my padlock? I became so curious and I wanted, as I was going to check on it, I was invaded. And there were creatures that came in the room and they were so ruthless and merciless. And they flooded. This looked like most of the Marvel character. It looked like the most... I still believe that this thing that these people portrays on TV are exactly how demons look like. You can sue me on this, you can refuse to believe me on this, but this is exactly what I saw in this dream. And it came and it landed on my bed, on top of me when I was in the sitting room. And it brought a very huge needle and it struck my head and it sucked out. And then I called upon the name of Jesus and I woke up and I was so terrified and I was so scared. This is what this dream means. Me being in this superhero thing, supporting them, motivating them, it means that we people, the children of light, the children of God, we are not aware of the things we are supporting. We are supporting the things of the world. We are like, wow, this is so nice. Oh, look, now they're bringing a robot into the world. Wow, this is amazing. Oh my God, there's now 5G technology. This is amazing. Look what they're doing to our world. Now we have fingerprint. They all have our fingerprint in our phone. I specifically can open my phone with my fingerprint. So these people have our fingerprint. And now we have a facial recognition. You can open your phone with your face. Wow. They all have our face. So this is what is happening. The children of God are not aware of what is happening. But today, plainly, boldly, I'm going to tell you the truth. Now when I was in this scene where my friend was trying to tell me, like, this padlock that you have, it can be opened from this other side. We think that you're protected. We think that, this thing is nothing. Because in this dream, I snubbed it when she told me this padlock, it can be opened from the other side. So we think we are safe wherever we are. We think that, oh, we are children of God. We are being ignorant of the devil devices. So we cannot believe anything. Even some people will still watch this video and will still not take heed of what I am saying. But I'm praying and I'm hoping that your heart will be softened. These people are really watching our move. They are watching everything we do. They are watching every step we take. Everything you post now, every picture you take, if it's saved by your Google, it already has the location and everything. They know where you are. They know who you are. They have your facial recognition. They have your fingerprint. And now they are bringing the chip. Everyone is like, wow, more advanced technology. Why are you advancing yourself materially? Why are you advancing yourself physically and you're not advancing yourself spiritually? Did you ask yourself that? You're being blinded by the things which are of vanity. Things will one day perish. And neglecting the things which are of the light, the things that will make you live eternally. Children of God, we need to wake up. Artificial intelligence is working hand in hand with the enemy, because what is yet to come, man having seen, it has not even come into the mind of man. I am telling you the truth. Pray, pray, let God reveal this to you. Because it is more than what we think. Me being in my house, in this dream I was in my house, like I had my family, I had my own husband, and yet, as of yet, I still don't have that desire. It really means the future of yet is to come. It might not happen now, but it's a preparation of what is yet to come. The devil is preparing something which is poisonous. He's working in haste and quickly to bring as many as he can to the kingdom of hell. And it's so unfortunate that many will be the children of light. Because why? Because he's working all this in order to make the children of God denounce Christ. And this is what is going to happen. Because now they have your facial recognition, they have your fingerprint, they have everything. They have all your details, where you stay, where you're located, when you go out, where you are. They can monitor every movement. This is now we are not talking about monitoring spirit. We are talking about men who are working for the kingdom of darkness against the men who are working for the children of light. This thing is happening plainly in the world, and I pray God to protect me, because I still have attacks. I pray God to protect me when I'm releasing this video, and I pray God to protect those who will take caution on what is yet to come. The devil is working against the children of light. Wake up, children of God. There is nowhere to run. There is nowhere to hide. Unless you really seek God, there is no escape. God, only God. Only God can flee us out of this. And it's really high time we seek God diligently with prayer and fasting. This is in the book of Joel chapter 2 verse 12. Now therefore, says the Lord, turn to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. So rend your heart and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and great to kindness. I tell you, if you go back to God, seeking repent, God is going to help you. And I pray that when you're seeking God to forgive you and to have mercy on you, that you still be strong and you will endure during this time. We are seeing what is happening in the world, coronavirus, we are seeing earthquake in Turkey, we are seeing locusts in East Africa, especially Kenya. There is so many things happening. Do not be blind. Do not be ignorant. There are some people who are still in their deathbed. They are old. They are turning 70. But they still do not want to turn to Christ. What are you waiting for? I still don't know what church is. I still don't know what people are waiting for. Are you waiting for a certain age? Are you waiting for a certain period? A certain sign? What are you waiting for? Seeking God, it can happen instantly. You don't have to wait for your dreams to come to pass, for a certain miracle to happen. I am telling you, once you die, you're burning in eternity. Imagine all the hustle and bustle you've been doing in this world, and you still go and die and go to hell and be burned eternity. Don't you think it's way better to hustle, bustle, and seek God? Like, really enduring and make it to eternal life. Because this journey is not easy. I'm not saying it is. It really is tough. There is a war going out there, and we need people who can fight. We need people who can fight. It's a matter of life and death, because God, please reveal to them, my God and my Savior, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Jireh. May you open their eyes. Let them see, oh God. Let them know what the enemy is working against their life, oh God. Open the eyes, oh God, of men. Open the eyes of women, my God. You say that your sons and your daughters shall see dreams and vision, oh God. May you pull down your spirit, oh God, during this time. Do not let us be ignorant of the devil's devices. Do not let us be blind of the plan of the enemy. I rebuke every spirit that is standing in front of their life, every strong man against them to see the things that the devil is planning against their life. I come against it. Each and every spirit that is not of God, that has hardened their heart, I rebuke you and I uproot you in the name of Jesus Christ. I was given power and authority over principalities, dominion, and forces of darkness. Hear me, queen of the sea. Hear me, queen of the ocean. Beelzebub, spirit, prince of Persia. Hear me, all you demon in Cubas and Secubas. You have no authority over the children of God. Arise, my God, from your throne and fight for your people, O Jehovah Nissi. Arise from your throne, O God, and send your army to fight on our behalf. Every arrows of temptation that is dragging us into vanity, that is blinding us, I remove that veil in the name of Jesus Christ. I rebuke that spirit that is making children of God be blind. In the name of Jesus Christ, devil, get thee behind me. Powers of darkness, get thee behind me. Get thee behind me. And every war that will happen around my life, I come against it. Every war that will happen upon everyone who's listening to this, I come against it. I shield them with the protection of God. I shield them with the fire of God. I shield them with the glory and the anointing of God. I shield them with the army of God. The Bible says we have been given power and we can command angels. I command the angels of God. I command angel Michael to fight for us in every battle that we cannot see, in our unseen battle. Let the army of God take over what we cannot see. In the name of Jesus Christ, may your eyes be open and may you see. I really pray that children of God will see. May God bless you. Amen.